Hello, my dear student. How are you all? Everyone fine? I hope everyone is doing great. Once again, let us start the case study discussion, and we are right now into case study number 13. Can we start a discussion? Yes, sir. Let's read. What is given? At the end of 40-year period, Bruce Limited has a legally enforceable obligation to demolish the factory and restore the site to its original condition. So of course, it is a question of provision for dismantling, restoration, etc. Because there is a legally enforceable obligation, so of course, we should create a provision. The directors estimated cost of demolition at the end of 40-year time based on the price prevailing at that time will be 4 crore. An annual risk-adjusted discount rate which is appropriate to this project is 8%. Discount rate is also given. The present value of rupee 1 payable in 40-year time at an annual discount rate of 8% is 4.6 paise. You need to convert paise into rupees, so it will be 0.046 multiplied by how much? 4 crore. So what is the answer? 4 into 0.046 is equal to, it will be 0.184 crore. Okay, sir. Yes, sir. Let us come to second point. On 1st April 2001, Bruce Limited raised loan finance from European investor. The investor subscribed for euro 100 million at par. Bruce Limited incurred an incremental issue cost of 2 million. This is a transaction cost to be deducted from the loan amount financial liability. So can you see initial liability on 1/4/2021 will be equal to how much? It is 100 minus 2, that is 98 euro. Okay, sir. Yes, sir. The interest of $8 million is payable annually on 31st March. It is payable, means it is contractual interest amount starting on 31st March 2022. The loan is repayable in euro after 10 years on 31st March 2031 at a premium. An effective interest rate implicit in the loan is given 10%. So 10% will be the effective rate of interest. So we need to recognize interest expense on 31st March at a rate of 10%, that will be 9.8 euro, and on 31st March how much payment has been done? 8 million euro. So what is the closing? That closing will be 98 plus 9.8 minus 8 is equal to how much? 99.8. The appropriate measurement basis for this loan is amortized cost. Relevant exchange rate are given. On 1st April 1 euro is equal to 82, so this will be multiplied by 82. On 31st March the rate become 85 and average rate is given 83. So interest expense will be by using average rate, and the payment has been done on 31st March, we'll take the exchange rate of that particular date. So that is how much? 85. Let's see what the question they have asked. Bruce Limited has a subsidiary, Gulf Limited. Gulf Limited has borrowed 10 crore through an intercorporate deposit from Bruce Limited for 1 year at an interest rate of 8% without any processing charges. The loan was given. Bruce Limited has a subsidiary. Gulf Limited has borrowed. It means Bruce Limited has given a loan for 1 year at an interest rate of 8%. However, the market rate of interest is 11% with an additional 1% toward processing charges. Means with processing charges, the market rate of interest is 12%. Without processing charges, the market rate of interest is 11%, because the loan was given without any processing charges. So we'll take, consider 11% only. So what will be the fair value of loan? The fair value of loan, you can see what is the contractual cash inflow that we need to find out. So at contractual cash inflow at year end 1 will be 10 crore plus interest. So 10 crore plus interest, so 8% is how much? 8% will be 0.8. So total inflow is what? 10.08. Now let us multiply by present value factor. So it will be 10.8 divided by 1.11. Correct now. Is equal to, it will come how much? Around the present value is what? 9.73. You can say 9.73. It means, can I say, how the loan proceeds is what? 10 minus 9.73. So the difference is how much? So 10 minus 9.73 is equal to how much? 0.27. So what journal entry will be done? Journal entry will be what? Ki loan receivable account debit, investment in subsidiary account debit to bank. So this portion will be investment in subsidiary and this will be loan receivable. Correct? Let's see what the question they have asked. Bruce Limited is exploring the possibility of issuing preference share to raise fund in the future. This preference share would be redeemable at the option of holder and would carry a fixed dividend payout of 12,000 per annum. So of course this is will be classified as financial liability because both principal and interest, there is obligation to pay. There is a mandatory obligation to pay. However, Bruce Limited decided to understand the accounting implication in the Ind AS before proceeding with the issuance. Okay, let's see what are the MCQ question. Which one of the following is appropriate classification of annual payment of 12,000 on the proposed issue of preference shares? Because it is classified as financial liability, so whatever dividend expense you recognize by calculating EIR, so let us assume in this case contractual rate of interest and EIR are same. So whatever is the contractual payment, that will be only interest expense. So this 12,000 will be considered as what? Interest expense. So interest expense, this will be the correct option. Understood? Yes, sir. Coming to point number 2, at the end of 40-year period, Bruce Limited has a legally enforceable obligation to demolish the factory. Cost of demolition recognized as a provision would be, already we calculated, how much we calculated? 0.184 crore, correct? So 0.184 crore, it will be 18.4 lakh converted into lakhs. Don't be confused with this option. So option number C is correct. So crore you need to convert in lakh. So that is 18.4 lakhs. In respect loan given to Gulf Limited, what is the income to be recognized by Bruce Limited in its standalone profit and loss account? So we need to find out how much income to be recognized in respect of loan given to Gulf Limited. Means this is related to this para. So how much fair value of loan we can see? 9.73 we have recognized. 9.73 into what? The EIR will be 11%. 11%, so this will be 1 crore point. So interest income will be 1.0703. So this much crore interest income should be recognized. Correct now. So we will find out interest income by applying EIR on fair value of loan. So let's see what the option has been given. So 12 lakh, of course this is not correct. 12 lakh as interest income and 4 lakh as interest expense. What is this? This is also not correct. Correct na? This loan is what? 10 crore na? 10 crore. So 10 crore. What they have given? Only, I think the option is not correct. 7 lakh as interest income and 11 lakh as interest. So I will say there is no correct option because the interest expense, interest income will be what? 1.0703 crore, and no option is correct. This you can see, no option is correct. So I will say in this, no option is correct. There may be some question which has been designed wrongly. So if they have given wrong question, don't worry, you'll be given full marks. You'll be given full marks for that. Okay, I will say don't put any option. Write down somewhere that this, there is no correct option given. No correct option given. Calculate a closing balance of loan finance as on 31st March 2022 with Bruce Limited has raised from European investor. So you need to find out the closing balance of loan. The closing balance in euro, already we calculated 99.8. So 99.8 multiplied by closing rate. What is the closing rate? 85 into 85. How much it is coming? 8483. So answer is 8483 crore. So 8483. Okay, the amount is given in what? Millions. So it will be 8483 millions. 8483 millions. So if you convert in crore, of course it will be 848.30 crore. So this is first option is correct. What is the next point? Calculate the exchange difference of loan finance from the European investor to be recognized in the profit or loss for the year ended. Now they want to calculate you exchange gain or loss. So let us find out exchange gain or loss. So what is the closing balance? Closing balance we calculated 8483. Now let us find out this, how much it is coming. So 98 into 82, how much? It is 803. 6, then 9.8 into 83, it is coming 813.4, then 8 into 85, this is coming how much? 680. So what is the balance? 8036 plus 813.4 minus 680 is equal to how much? It is 8169.4. What is the difference? So you can say liability increases, so there is an exchange loss. So minus 8483 is equal to what? 313.6. So 313.6 million. 313.6 million. So it will be 31.36 loss. So option number B is correct. Option number B is correct. Be careful about gain and loss. If the liability increases, so there is an exchange loss. Understood? I hope all the para we have done. The first option number B, interest expense of 12,000, correct? Option number C, we have done, means point number 2 ka, what we have done? Point number 2 ka. Option number C, we have done 18.4. This is also correct. For point number 3, you can see they have also given no correct option. There is no correct option. I will see that has not been designed correctly. But in exam, there is a very less chances for that. Don't worry about that. Then 4 ka option number A we have done. Yes, option number A. And 5 ka option number B we have done. Yes, it is also correct. So all the points we have done. I hope you have understood this case study. Okay. Bye-bye. We'll meet again in the next video. Bye-bye.